my name is Joshua Cooley. I'm an electrical engineering major and team lead for the Charlotte 49er Miners. Here at UNC Charlotte, our team has designed and built a prototype lunar rover to compete in the annual NASA Lunabotics competition. In this competition, 50 teams will battle to showcase their innovations and design.
My name is Andrew Romero. I'm a computer engineering major and I worked on automation code.
My name is Charles Roberts. I'm an electrical engineering major and I worked on the autonomy.
My name is Tyler Chapin. I'm electrical and computer engineering major and I worked on the power distribution panel, the electrical layout, and autonomy.
I'm Angela and I'm a mechanical engineering major and I worked on the NASA presentation, the public outreach report, and the systems engineering paper.
My name is Kramer Ward Collins. I'm a mechanical engineering technology major and I worked on the inner drum nozzle and the conveyor belt deployment.
My name is Jared Jakowitz. I'm a mechanical engineering major and I worked on the conveyor belt.
My name is Jason Eichenling and I'm a mechanical engineering technology major and I worked on the conveyor belt.
My name is Deepal Shah and I'm a system engineering major and I worked on the system engineering paper.
What is one word to describe the Charlotte 49er Miners?
Creative.
Technical.
Team-oriented.
Passionate.
Multi-talented.
Goal-driven.
Hardworking.
Diligent.
With the help from North Carolina Space Grant, 49er Miners were able to build a rover that traversed a lunar-like arena that consisted of obstacle and digging zones. The rover will dig in a predetermined excavation zone and then transport the mined material into a collection bin on the other end of the arena. The rover was tasked with digging down 30 centimeters to reach a layer of simulated regolith. The excavation drum was modified to mitigate the loss of regolith that previous years experienced. This was accomplished by creating a nozzle embedded within the drum that controlled the flow of the depositing onto the conveyor belt. In analysis, it was in our best interest to remove the previous stabilization system and create a larger conveyor belt. To accompany NASA's size constraints, the frame of the conveyor belt was designed to fold onto itself. A linear actuator was added for the deployment of this compact design, and a metal frame was CNC'd to be more durable and withstand a sizable mass. 3D printed walls were added to mitigate loss of regolith from the sides of the belt, which was a problem of previous years. The electrical subsystem was completely redesigned. We introduced a power distribution panel, and that monitored and regulated the amount of power each device needed. The power distribution panel was designed using EagleCAD. This printed circuit board supplied our system with 16 connections of 12 volts with a large multi-layer ground plane for our voltage return and noise mitigation. This PCB was manufactured, however, our connections were physically soldered and tested to keep costs down. A complete rewiring of the rover was also introduced for organization and to accommodate ease of troubleshooting. Autonomy has been broken up into two subsystems, navigation and control. Our navigation system uses a group of devices called POSICs to localize the rover within the arena. Developing an X and Y coordinate system for the arena allowed us to create various paths. POSICs will continuously identify where the rover travels within the arena. As mentioned earlier, obstacles will be randomly placed within the arena. To solve this problem, the team implemented a depth sensing camera to be able to detect anything directly in front of the rover to navigate around it. These objects are identified by the camera and will allow us to plot the object for further avoidance. The second part of autonomy was achieved by using a series of encoders paired with the code to complete the digging and depositing processes as many times as possible within the given competition time. Without the help from the North Carolina Space Grant, our project would not have achieved the goals that we have set.
Thank you, NC Space!